Hello and welcome to this session on Jenkins. This is the fourth session of this series, and today we are going to see how to use the command line tool for Jenkins and how you can control various actions on Jenkins without a UI and using it a command line interface. Okay, now the very first question is, why should I move to command line, right? I can do all the things from the UI of Jenkins, so why should I even bother to go to command line and do all the actions? So the reason for going to command line is it is easier, it is faster and more convenient. You will also have to worry about the memory management, right? So it is more efficient if you go to command line because it will consume less memory than the UI, and then of course the continuous integration, when you have to do a continuous integration or set up a build process, then you will have to go to the command line, and that is why we have to use a command line interface for Jenkins. Okay, now mostly it happens is that the beginners for any tool, after getting some good basic understanding, they move to command line. But we are having this session as the fourth session of this series, and this is because if you are an automation engineer or if you are a developer or a software engineer, whatever, whenever you start with a new tool, always try to look for the command line integration of that tool. And it is very easy and convenient to have a command line execution and control over your tool. Okay, so let us begin, and it's going to be very easy. In three or four basic steps I will tell you how exactly you can get started with command line of Jenkins. So step one is start Jenkins, and we will do the same thing as we have learned in our last sessions. If you are on Mac, you will go to terminal. If you are on Windows, you can go to command line, and you have to go to the location of your jenkins.war. So I will go to my location of my jenkins.war, and it is at desktop tools Jenkins. Okay, and then we have to say java-jar jenkins.war. And this will start my Jenkins on the default port, which is 8080. In case you want to change the port, you can say --, HTTP port, and whatever port you want to start Jenkins on. Okay, as of now, I just want to start it on the default 8080 port. So I'll just click enter, and it will start my Jenkins. Okay, so let me go to my browser and go to localhost 8080. So my Jenkins is getting started. Okay, now my Jenkins should be fully up and running, and yes, it is up. Okay, so now what you have to do is you have to go to manage Jenkins here. Okay, so I will also write it down. Step two is go to manage Jenkins. And then you have to go to configure global security. Okay. And here, make sure that this enable security is checked. Okay. Apply and save. So this should be checked. Okay, enable security, sorry. Okay, now what we can do is, as step number three, what you can do is whatever your URL is, for example mine is localhost 8080, you put a forward slash and say CLI. Okay, so I will say go to CLI. So this portion, the first portion, can be anything as per your system. It can be some IP here instead of localhost, and can be any port, whatever your Jenkins is working on. You just have to append CLI here and as I will do this, you can see the Jenkins CLI window comes up. Okay, and here they have given a wiki. So if you want some detailed information, you can go to their wiki and you can read this Jenkins wiki for CLI. Okay, and then they have given this URL to download the jar, and you can just click here and your Jenkins CLI jar will get downloaded. Okay, so what you have to do is, step 4 is download Jenkins CLI jar and place at any location on your system. So whatever location you want to run the build commands from, you can save this jar to that location. Okay, and then what to test the jar is working, right? Now we have to, step 5 is test the jar, or you can see Jenkins command line is working. What you have to do is go to your location wherever you have placed this jar file. Okay, so for example, I will go to my terminal. In Windows, you can go to your command prompt and go to the location wherever your Jenkins CLI jar is placed. So I have placed my Jenkins CLI jar here inside tools, inside Jenkins desktop tools Jenkins, and I have created a folder Jenkins CLI, and I have placed my Jenkins CLI jar here. So I will go to this location from the terminal. Okay, so tools Jenkins Jenkins CLI. Okay, and now you can see they gave us these direct commands, and this UI is very intuitive. I have started my Jenkins on localhost 8080, so it is giving me the same URL here. If you start your Jenkins on any other port or IP, it will display that port and IP here. So what you have to do is, you just have to copy it from here and test on your command line or terminal. So I'll just copy it from here, place it here, and then run. Okay, now see, this is asking me for a passphrase. Okay, if you get the same thing, then what you can do is, if you do not know your passphrase, you can go to your Jenkins, and whatever user you have logged in as, it will be displayed here in the top right corner. Go to the drop down and go to configure, and here you have SSH public keys. Here you can set any of your public keys or any passphrase. Okay, and the same passphrase you can use here if asked for. Okay, so see, I just ran that command and I'm getting all the possible options. Okay, so it is also given here. So you can do all these things. You can add a job, you can do a build, you can do shutdown, restart, and so many other things, right? So let us test it and let us do a safe restart. So if you can click here, you will actually get the command. And again, this is very intuitive. This will actually give you the exact command for your instance. So because I am localhost 8080, it is giving me the same URL here. So I can just copy it from here and go to my terminal, paste it, and run the command. Okay, did you notice it is saying me, it is giving me some error, anonymous is missing the overall administrator permission. Okay, so in that case, what you can do is, you can go to manage Jenkins, configure global security, and here in the authorization, I'm just changing anyone can do anything. just for this session I want to test, and I am saving this. Okay, and let me run the command again. And yes, now it is restarting, and you can see the on the window where Jenkins I have was started, it is saying restart in 10 seconds, so it is going to restart my Jenkins now. Okay, so Jenkins is stopped and now they are restarting it. Yes, now the Jenkins is started. Okay, so see, there are a lot of other options, and you can do almost all the actions like building a job or adding a job, deleting a job, and so many other things, right? Installing a plugin is also there, install tool is there, right? So in the coming sessions we will look more deeply into command line interface and what all we can do. For this session you should be just be able to get started with command line, and then you can do some hands-on and, you know, keep playing around with command line so that you can get more knowledge. Okay, happy learning, hope you like it. Thank you.